slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Eluding the pressure right. Right side catch, Gilmore. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Now a play fake here on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the legend, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. And the Giants ready to come out now. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. But they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
That throw good for four. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that one?
And he is going to go down. He will be sacked on the final play of this first quarter. Larry Ridley, I'm Brandon Gauden with Charles Davis. We are ready for this draft champions matchup as you get a quick peek at some of the stars in today's game. We're ready to go. Let's get down to kickoff. The getting to know each other process is over. Time to get down to it. And we're off in week three of Draft Champions. Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. Brady now on first down. Caught on the right side by Jones. They'll get 23 yards there. And that'll be good for a Giants first. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Caught left side, Gilmore. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them. As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And it appears they'll go for it here on fourth down. A big call on the game's opening drive. Brady gonna go on fourth down.
Jason Pierre-Paul first burst on the scene for me, headed towards his draft year. You know what I saw him doing? like 15, 16 backflips in a row on a YouTube video.
Athlete.
Absolute athlete. And he uses that agility to slip past guys and make plays in the backfield.
That draft year 2010, 15th overall pick. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running back quicker than ever before.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and it'll be third and 10. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third down.
Could be a blitzer.
Throwing now is Brady. Steps away. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
To throw is long. And he's got his man in stride, complete. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
I'll give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
Wide open receiver complete. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Luck on first down. Being chased out left. His throw incomplete.
I think that's a big time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
On second and 10, Luck. Complete to Gilmore over the middle. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a play caller. Because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence. Slants are so tough to cover because everything happens so fast. But sometimes it happens too fast for the guy catching the ball because all of his movements have to be quick off the line of scrimmage, and then all of a sudden the ball's right on top of you. And maybe he got a little bit ahead of himself there.
A lot of times coming in with good pace, and he dropped it. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Throwing on third down. Luck throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. They'll give him a yard on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0. So after slogging through a scoreless first quarter, we have action on the scoreboard. A field goal makes it 3-0.
Well, with these two offenses, we weren't going to stay 0-0 forever, were we? I'm not sure that this opens the floodgates, but I doubt that's the last scoring we're going to see.
And New York set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Will tie the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
In the backfield is Anderson. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44.
Stephon Tua came out of Notre Dame as another one of those really tall defensive ends, and just wondered, would they be able to have the leverage to bend and make plays? I think he just gave us an answer with that tackle.
A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
They do go for it. It's Brady. And it is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But let's have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Now Love, sliding out of the pocket. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. Love. And he'll find his man on the out route. That's Allen. He gets 7 out of it, and he also gets a first.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did. That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the...
Throwing is Love. Well, there was no blitz. That was just a draw play that, to be frank, didn't fool anybody.
Did we hear the entire stadium screaming draw? Because
it felt like everybody was all over
that play, and the defense won that battle. How about that scramble by Andrew Luck? Sometimes we forget just how big, strong, and yes, fast Andrew Luck is. When he came out of college at the combine, shocked everyone, ran us.
And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Second and goal. They still need 8 yards to find the end zone. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Their big-bodied receiver. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Ravens have used the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know. Are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room, get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes, coach, that's it, okay? It hasn't worked all game.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. One receiver left, 3 to the right. To throw, it's Brady. He's going to let it fly. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming in. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. It's the former Patriot, Devin McCourty. And that will write a finish to this ball game.